The Topaz Video Enhance AI version 2.3 release has several new features. In the last tutorial, I looked at the new Proteus model. This time I'm looking at the new smooth slow motion options using the new Chronos model. And the next tutorial after this will look at a review converting frame rates using the Chronos model. And finally, the third review will reinforce the options available in the new Proteus model. Anyway, let's look at the process to create a smooth slow motion and slow down by up to 2000%. But to be a little bit more realistic, I'll use 800% in this exercise. And to give you some comparisons, I'll slow down a clip in Final Cut Pro to 12.5% of the original speed and compare that by using the Chronos model in Topaz with an 800% reduction in speed. From a practical point of view, slowing down video clips actually stretches the space between the real frames of video. So something needs to fill those gaps. Let's look at the process in Final Cut Pro. By default, when you ask Final Cut Pro to slow down a clip, it uses a normal frame stretching process, and this will look very jittery. Final Cut Pro does offer two slow-mo options, that's frame blending for slow-mo close to the original speed, and optical flow, which is best selected when the rate of change is 20% or less. Frame blending stretches each frame's time on the screen and tries to smooth the movement from one frame to the next, which you may think of a type of cross-dissolve transition. Optical flow, on the other hand, creates new frames with what Final Cut imagines those extra frames should look like. It's a form of AI, as is the Topaz model, but they do it in different ways. Let's see which is the best, or if there's any visible difference. Since I'm slowing the clip down by less than 20%, I'll use the optical flow version in Final Cut. So select the clip and with Command plus R, select the custom speed control and type in 12%, which is the closest that Final Cut Pro will accept to 12.5%. To use the optical flow, navigate to the gauge icon, select Video Quality, Optical Flow. An optical flow is not instantaneous, so it will take some time to render, and it will depend on the length of your clip. Now I'll play through the clip in Final Cut Pro, and then as an exported clip using QuickTime. Let's look at the process in Topaz Video Enhance, and I'll compare that with the Final Cut files and see if you can see the difference. First, I'll import the same file into Topaz. Next, select all models and find Chronos Slow Mode. Then select 800% from the Slow Mo menu. For this exercise, I'll set the output to ProRes 422. Now press the preview button and check all is okay. And this is where the file will be output to your hard disk. When you're ready to stop the preview, then you can start your processing of the slow-mo file. In this case, I've got 18 clips for processing, but I only want to do one of them. The time is stated at 16 minutes, but that's going to dramatically change as the processing continues. This file actually took 1 hour and 20 minutes to complete. And when it's complete, you'll see a blank screen and you'll be able to locate your files in the Finder from here at the bottom of your screen. Clicking and pressing on the spacebar in the Finder will play the clip. Now let's play the two versions together and compare the differences. Both versions are playing here in QuickTime. The Topaz version is on the left, and the Final Cut version on the right. And as they play through, look out for some jittery jumping movement in the eyes of the lion that's closest. The Topaz version is smoother, but is it worth the difference in time to produce? The Topaz version took 1 hour and 20 minutes to process. The Final Cut version took less than a minute for the optical flow to render. So it's your decision. The next tutorial will look at more detail in the frame rate conversion using Chronos model in Topaz Video Enhance. I'm looking forward to it. See you there.